Sumaya from Qatar.
Brother, my question is regarding the day of Arafat. In Qatar, in Saudi, we all celebrated, I mean, we all fasted the fast of Arafat on the 5th of November. But in India, it was the day after. Like, for them, the calendar was in such a way that the Arafat was celebrate, I mean, the Arafat fast, they kept on the day when we were celebrating Eid. So they always said regarding this that Arafah is like one day. It should be the fast should be kept on one day. All the Ummah should keep the fast on one day. So what is the ruling regarding this? That can they approach their community and keep the fast on the day? Like they can follow the Saudi itself and like.
It's by the way, it's not about following the Saudis or following what particular country. Rather, it is which opinion do we go by? Ittihad al-Matala or Ikhtilaf al-Matala. So, if India or whatever country they have their own moon citation and they go out in the beginning of every lunar month to sight the moon and say, yes, now we can fast, or this is the beginning of Muharram, this is the beginning of Safar, this is the beginning of whatever. So, if they go by that, so whatever beginning of Dhul-Hijjah. The ninth will be according to their moon citation, like Ramadan exactly. We don't have a problem with that. But if it is like a trend, if Saudis are experiencing the ninth on the fifth, then we've got to be on the 6th of November, a day before or a day after. This is not a game. Islam does not play games with politics. Islam is beyond boundaries. There is nothing called India and Saudis and Egypt. Islam is a universal religion. So if you know, you guys, that the authorities are in this country, deliberately, on purpose, they have to change the day so that they would not be following this particular country, I would not go by them. Rather, I would go by those who are standing on Arafah on that day. The other view says what? Ittihad al-Matala, who says that if the moon was sighted in any Muslim country, it doesn't have to be Saudi. It could be Pakistan, the neighboring country, Bangladesh, Egypt, Jordan, any Muslim country. It is sufficient. Two just Muslims were able to see the moon once it was born, the crescent, is sufficient for the 1.6 million, billion to start fasting or to celebrate Eid on the particular day. By the way, Sumaya, last episode, I got a call from a woman from the Maldives. She said she's stayed in India and they celebrated Eid a few days off. We're not talking about only one day, as you said. And I personally know that in some countries, like in Bangladesh, it could be 3 or 4 days as well. So if you guys go out and you sight the moon and you go by Ikhtilaf al-Matala and you have your own moon citation, I would respect that. This is a respected view. But if you go by calculations, because they printed the calendar from the beginning of the year that the Arafah will be on that day, so they disregard moon citation, you should disregard their calculations whatsoever. This is our deen. And when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Siyamu yawmi Arafah ahtasibu ala Allah," fasting on the day of Arafah, I hope and I believe that it will expiate the sins of the past year and the year to come. We should be very careful with that. ولا أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters, until next episode, I leave you in the care of Allah. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Allah is my heart's speech. Your mercy is what I beseech. Keeping my heart your remembrance and in your deen allow me to advance. Help me in my quest, permit me to pass the ultimate test. Help me in my quest.